Hello everyone. Hello, hello. What is going on? Yeah, of course. Yes, anyone who got a reading before like noon today, your reading is out. Everyone else must wait until Monday. I'm so sorry. What's going on? How's everyone doing? How's everyone feeling? Oh my god. Oh my god, am I getting sick? What the fuck? What's going on? Does anyone have any updates? Anything crazy happen? Oh, I really want to know, like, what do you guys want to see? You're sick too? Jesus, I don't know what's going on. It was kind of cold today, though. Maybe it's the weather change. Oh, thank you, Leanne, for responding to... Oh, wait, did you? Oh, wait, no, I'm looking at the glow-up challenge. Just kidding. Thank you for always posting in the glow-up challenge, though. I really appreciate that. But thank you to people who have suggested, like, what they want for my YouTube. If you guys want certain readings from YouTube, like, please tell me. Please tell me. Please. I'm revamping my YouTube. It's gotten a little slow. So, I need to go in there and just pivot. Hello, how are you? Oh, no. I'm so sorry. It's always so stressful when something like happens in a house because you have to do it yourself. Do you have homeowner's insurance? Homeowner's insurance is like amazing. Hello, hello. I'm making my schedule for next week while everyone is coming in here. Hello, Amy. messages. Mini messages. I don't think I have to do the... Okay. They aren't covering it because that line specifically is under maintenance. Can they fix your floors? Like, can they do something? It's a little fly. Ooh, there's someone watching. Get the fuck out. The fuck? Daily YouTube videos. I would try, like... Dude, I don't know, like... All the flies... I haven't had any flies in a couple of days. And I'm like, why are they back? I literally just, like, I cleaned the fuck out of this apartment, and I'm like, I'm gonna, like, actually scream. Is that it? Oh, subscriber message. Subscriber message. I think I have therapy next week, too. Therapy at 11, I think. Hello, hello. Yes, I'm about to start a collective. Sorry, I was just finishing up my schedule for next week. How's everyone doing? Hello. Hello, hello. It's a lot. It's a lot. That's why I got on so late today. We went and got our keys. We went into the apartment. I was like staring at my room talking about how the fuck am I going to fit everything in here? Because I need to get a new desk. So I was trying to figure that out. And who's trying to see you? Huh? Anyway. Oh my god, that fucking fly. I'm going to kill you. Anyway. Yeah, so we got the keys and everything, and I put some stuff, like, I took some stuff over there already, and so, yes, I'm moving again. It's a whole thing. This apartment, I'm very thankful for it because that's a whole other story. But I need to get out of here. So I'm moving again. Yes. Past video, it said someone coming toward me to fight and meet me across Canada. Sir, I'm gonna need you to be a little bit more specific because Canada. Was I talking about Canada in a video? I don't remember. I don't recall. Sir, I don't know what to tell you. I don't know, John. Coming to fight you or fight to be with you? Oh, thank you, Angel. I appreciate that. Yes, to be with me. I don't even remember what video that is. I'm not gonna lie to you. I do a lot of readings every single day. I'm so sorry. I do not have specifics for you. I don't even remember. I don't even recall. I do. I have some mascara on and I have some eyeliner on the waterline. That's about it though. That's about it. And then I have the green canceling makeup on as well. Oh, thank you. Have a good night. Oh, thank you. I do have a slight filter on right now. I have to be honest. I have no idea. Sorry. I just ate something I'm allergic to. You guys know the drill. That reminds me, like, because I was about to be like, who's Quinn? That reminds me of Kiki Palmer when she was like, I don't even know who this man is. I have no idea who that is. Thank you, guys. You guys are so nice. Thank you. All right, should we do a collective? I'm allergic to, like, everything. I'm not even joking. I'm allergic to everything. I'm allergic to anything with, like, preservatives in it. It just, like, makes my throat gunk up really bad. It makes me cough. I don't know what to do at this point. Because I won't be able to eat anything. I just, like... Anyway. I can't. I don't know what to do. I'm just gonna suffer. Suffer through it. So... Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Okay. Everyone listen for your sign. But Alex, my ex is a Leo. Okay, what do you want me to do about it? I don't know what to tell you. We're doing your sign. Yes, Mercury is officially out of the microwave, so we can all breathe. Aries, we have the Queen of Swords and the Six of Cups. Dude, I need an EpiPen. I do. Okay. Aries, Queen of Swords, Six of Cups. I think a memory is gonna come up for you. That feels like a memory to me. Aries, a memory is going to come up for you about your childhood. Taurus, oh my god. I'm sorry. I say Chinese food. It was really good though, so it was worth it. It's worth the suffering. Okay, Taurus, we have, the Strength and the Star. Let me turn this shit down real quick. Taurus, you're getting a really big manifestation. I don't know what else to say. It's coming. Hello, Melise. Really big manifestation. So keep holding on. Gemini, Two of Swords, and the Two of Wands reverse. Gemini, okay, that sounds like 222. I feel like you're about to make a really big relationship decision, Gemini. I feel like you don't want to put effort into one of these people, so you should probably not be with them. I know that sounds obvious, but if I'm talking to like the crazy Geminis, I feel like you need to be told. Some of you Geminis need help. I'm talking about the evil twins. You know, we have the twins here with the Geminis, okay? Chanel, how are you feeling? But the evil Geminis, you guys need to get help. The evil twins need to get help. Bad? Oh my God, recovery is not fun right now. Cancer, we have the Three of Pentacles and the Four of Pentacles reversed. Cancer, I'm gonna need you to save your coin. No more $700 Amazon purchases. Stop going out with your coworkers and like binge drinking after work, okay? Leo, Three of Cups reversed and the Empress. Leo, you're gonna find out, I'm sorry, this is really karmic-y, but Leo, you're gonna find out that someone that like cheated on you like is either like pregnant or got somebody pregnant. I can't wait for all of my exes to have babies. I can't wait, because that means they'll officially stop thinking about me and sending me their energy. Pay attention to your kid. Pay attention to your child. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate you and I appreciate that child and I appreciate the baby mama. I'm sending everybody flowers. Thank you. Anyway, as a Leo rising, that's my take on it. Virgo, Five of Cups reverse, and the Sun. Yeah, Virgo, you're coming out of a grieving process very, very soon, and you're walking into the Sun. You're about to be really happy, Virgo. I love that for you. I'll stop my exes with another one while I dealt with the loss. Oh, I'm so sorry. I mean, it may not happen, you know? It may not happen for everyone, you know? Maybe it's just me. Maybe all of my exes are getting married and, like, having babies. I don't know what that says about me. My job forced me to come back to work prematurely. Is that illegal? That has to be illegal. That has to be illegal. I would sue. The way I would sue. I would sue them for everything they have. You almost caused my death, workplace. Hell no. Okay. Who's next? That was Virgo. Libra's next. Libra, Four of Swords, Six of Pentacles in the reverse. Libra, you need to sit down. You need to sit down and rest. Stop giving everybody everything. Rest. Give that energy back to yourself. Calm down. Sit down. Take a bath. Take a bubble bath. Scorpio, the Moon reverse and the Eight of Pentacles. Ooh, Scorpio. Secrets at work are going to be revealed. How exciting. The tea. Sagittarius, we have the World and the Page of Wands. Sorry. Page of Wands and the World. Wow, Sagittarius, I love that. I feel like you're going to be traveling a lot, Sagittarius. Okay. Lots of travel coming your way. Ooh. I like it. The doctor verbally told me to go back Monday. It was not okay to come back, but had to. So I went, oh. So I would sue the doctor and work. I'd sue everybody. Everyone. I don't know. You'll have to tell me if it's good or bad. Capricorn, Death, and the King of Pentacles in the reverse. Capricorn, you need to redo your budget. You need to like really look at the way that you've been spending money because what you're doing right now is not working. Sorry. Aquarius, the Hermit, and the Justice reverse. Aquarius, you're not going to get what you want by staying in the house. Damn, I feel called out. Pisces, Ace of Cups, and the Six of Swords. Pisces, you can fall in love, but you have to move on. I don't know what else to tell you. Stop going back to your ex who cheated on you 1,000 times. There's someone waiting for you on the other side. Like, what are you doing? Hello? Okay. Get in. Oop. What'd I miss? So I wouldn't get in trouble, but he submitted my paperwork today and told them I need 2 weeks, not 3 days. Good. I'd already been back for 5 days. Oh my God. I can't believe your work wasn't like, she might die. Let's send her home. Can the doctor get in trouble for that? Yeah, I'm doing personals. I just don't have any right now. So I'm just yapping. Does anyone have any questions for me? Not free tarot questions. I don't care about your ex coming back. Not for free anyway. What makes an influencer sound tone deaf? I'm so sorry. I'm really annoying. What makes an influencer sound tone deaf? You know that girl who's... every time I see someone try to, like, talk about this video, I scroll immediately because it makes me so angry. There's this girl who got on here who... I don't know where she is. I think she's somewhere, like, in Africa. She's a white girl. She's somewhere... I don't know if she's vacationing. I don't know if she moved there. I don't know. Now, have you guys seen this video? She's there, and she's like, I have to say, I'm the prettiest girl here. First of all, you sound racist. Second of all, is she in Africa? That's where she is, right? I don't know. Am I wrong? Does anyone know where she is? Did someone put it in the comments? Anyway, I think that's where she was. She moved there. Oh my God. Can you imagine moving there permanently and talking about how you're the, oh, there it is. Okay. No, you're good. Can you imagine moving to a space like that and be like, I'm the prettiest girl here? Like, girl. What? Oh, thank you. Hello, hello. Okay. I feel like, and you guys hear me say this all the time, so I'm gonna stop talking shit, even though she, you know, she deserved to be called out. But I believe that if you get on the internet and you start talking shit about other people, you need to be ready for everyone to go into your closet and take your skeletons out. You need to be ready for all of your demons to be exposed. None of us are perfect. All of us have done things that we see as mistakes or whatever. You know, all of us have things that we don't want on the internet. You know, deep, dark secrets, embarrassing moments that we don't want on the internet, right? So if you're going to get on the internet and say shit like that, unwarranted, like unprovoked, I think that if you get on the internet and you're just like, if you're not talking about stuff, okay, how do I word this? Because I know that like gossiping has its place, right? Like that's how we all make sure that we're safe, right? We all go down to the local Chili's with our girls and we get drinks. Hello, how are you? Like we're gossiping, we're kikiing, you know, we're talking. But I think like talking about what we've heard without necessarily being mean isn't that bad or isn't bad at all. Does anyone know what I'm saying? Because I feel like we can reflect on like what's so say like you're going out to drinks with your coworkers and you're talking about what happened at work. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. But I think if you were to get on the internet and then be like, I'm going to spill all the tea about my coworkers, say their names, put their pictures up here. What the fuck is wrong with you? Like, you know, I don't like that. So I think like that's what makes people tone deaf. Like getting on here expecting their viral moment, but they're doing it in a really negative way. They're doing it in a way to like they're putting other people down in order to get their viral moment, you know? How come show their lifestyle but still seem nice with grace? Oh, so how can they show their lifestyle? I see where you're coming from, because you probably like, because I remember your questions from, I read over your questions from Discord a little bit this afternoon, and I think that you can show people your lifestyle. Be who you are. Be exactly who you are. As long as you recognize your privilege in this world, no one's gonna have a problem with you. You're always gonna have like a couple of haters who are like, oh my gosh, this rich girl, who wants to watch her? But as long as you're a nice person, I mean, like, that you shouldn't be punished because your parents had money and were able to raise you properly. Like, all of us who grew up without money wished that we had that. So I would never hate on anybody. And, you know, I was very bitter towards people in high school. I was very bitter and jealous of the kids who had money. But, like, I also went to school with a lot of really, really nice kids who had money. Like, a lot of them were super, super, super nice. Some of them were assholes, but at the end of the day, I always knew that it came down to parenting. It comes down to parenting, like how you are. It always comes down to how you grew up and like how you were parented, you know? Okay. Let's do Alex's reading. So many Alexes in here. Alex, what are we doing tonight? Yeah, well, and that's the thing, like, some people are gonna be like, oh, she was a rich girl, she was mean, but if they can't come, people are always gonna have something to say, you know? And I genuinely believe that if you are trying to be a good person, like, you're genuinely learning from your mistakes and trying to be a good person now, like, what are we supposed to do? It's different when it comes to like violence, right? Like if you were like violent towards people, then I would be like, okay, well, but you didn't lend this girl a ruler. If she got on the internet and was like, well, Amy didn't lend me a ruler because she has money, people are going to be like, what? Yeah. Worried about my boss. I think he stalks me and may end up physically. Huh? Are you serious? Hello, hello, everyone. Oh my God, that's a really big deal. I'm looking for other options, but impossible to match what he pays me. Do you think he's stalking you because he has a crush on you? Like that kind of vibe? Okay, well, let's see. Spirit, can you just get some advice for Alex? What do you need him to do? If you... I mean, if you can somehow get proof, I don't know. But you're just gonna have to take the pay cut. Like, is your life really worth, like, the high pay? You know? You're just gonna have to, if you need to downsize your house, apartment, then do what you need to do. If you need to get some roommates to save money. That's weird. What kind of like field do you work in? Obviously you don't have to put where you work, but like what do you do? We have advice for Alex. What's going on? So we start with the star, and then we have the seven of cups. So this is you manifesting options. You're gonna have to take the pay cut. I'm so sorry. Like, I hate it. It's coming out in the cards too. We then have the king and the queen of pentacles, both in the reverse. It's like no matter which way you spin it, like, you still have to take a cut in pay. If you're genuinely worried about your life, a cut in pay is like, it is what it is. And I hate to say that, but like, I would find a new job. I wouldn't even give notice. You don't have to give notice. That's not like, it's not illegal to just like quit on the spot, you know? Obviously have something lined up. If you need to pick up a side hustle, pick up a side hustle. But like, if you're used to living a certain lifestyle because of how much money you make, you're just gonna have to get used to not living that lifestyle for a little bit longer, just until you can, you know, get that money up again. I hate to say this, like, I really wish there was like a better solution. We then have the devil and the two of wands reverse. Like, you have to go about this very, very carefully. Trying to save money to move away from my ex-girlfriend, who is also scary. These two cards tell me that you need to make a very strategic plan. If your life really is like in danger, then you need to just pick up what you have and go somewhere. Try to find some roommates. No, I get it. I feel like this whole reading is just like, you need to just bite the bullet and do what you need to do to keep yourself safe. I know it's like not that simple, like just like pack up your stuff in your car and go. But I don't see it getting any better. And it's just like, the longer you wait, the worse it gets. That's what I get from these two cards. This is like not wanting to take risks. I don't want to make a plan. And the devil, yeah, we know who the devil is. But then it's like, we have the six of swords and the king of wands. After that, like, you have a choice here. Six of swords is moving on to calmer waters, and the king of wands is finally feeling confident. It's being courageous. It's loyalty as well. Just feeling a lot better about yourself. Overall, this is why I'm like, it's not going to get better. Eight of cups reversed and the three of cups reversed. It's like third party energy, and it keeps coming back with the eight of cups reversed. Listen, if your boss really is stalking you, it doesn't matter if you're working for him or not. He's still going to try to find you. So I feel like the only thing that you can really do right now is try to move. And I know that that's expensive, but like, if you can just, you can sell the stuff that you have, get some cash in your pocket, move to a different city if you can, get some roommates, and say goodbye to everything. Like, is there something in particular that's like, do you have kids? Or like, is there something in particular that's like keeping you stuck there? I'm worried once I try to quit, it will actually get worse with him because he's unstable. Yeah, what I would do is I would like try to secure, oh, you have three animals. What I would do is I would try to secure a job in another city. Don't tell anybody about it. I wouldn't even tell like your friends or anything about it. Like, I would keep it so hush hush, it's like not even funny. But like, as soon as you get the job, I would quit on the spot and I would leave. If you need to get a hotel for a couple of weeks or whatever, then you can do that while you work. And then you can try to find roommates. Nice. Okay, at least you're trying. Can you move back in with your parents? Is that not an option? Or do you already live with your parents? Listen, if you're gonna stay, restraining order against your ex-girlfriend, first of all. Like, if you're not just going to pick up and move, or if you can't move back in with your parents or whatever, if that's not, like, the right thing for you to do, to live with your parents, restraining order against the ex-girlfriend. You tell her to leave you alone. She says no. Restraining order. You quit your job. They live in a small apartment, but are willing to look for a house to accommodate me with my animals. Oh, okay. Well, I would keep working together with your parents then. Make that a priority. Yeah. Make that a priority. I mean, is it like, are they trying to buy a house? At least you have your parents' support. I mean, you could bite the bullet and just move back in with your parents. It's going to be a tight fit and it's not going to be fun, but at least you'll be safe, you know? Oh my gosh, my stomach is growling so loud. I literally just ate. Anyway, I do want dessert though. Anyway, find one to rent. This is the first time I've ever been. First time for everything. What I would do is I would quit your job. I would literally quit. And if he starts to get crazy, restraining order. Call the police in restraining order. I'm like, not even joking. I don't, like, there's no other solution here. If you're worried about money, you're just going to have to take the pay cut. I feel like the emotions behind this are not simple, but the solutions are, you know? Yeah, document everything. Like, and when you quit, you have to block him on everything. Like, you know? I don't know what else to say. When is Alex's next positive change? I just feel like if you stay where you are, if you stay working for him, like, it's going to get worse. So you have to go. You have to leave. That's me in public and told me I needed to start documenting. Oh my God. Oh, interesting. Something about June. Did something happen in June for you? That feels like the past. We then have the full moon in 2 weeks. Is the full moon in 2 weeks? Something about you using the energy of the full moon. Yeah, I wish I had a better solution for you, but it seems like... Oh, really? I don't know. I feel bad. We have Capricorn and Aquarius energy here. I just feel like... This is difficult, but the solutions are very simple. Like, nothing is ideal, but this whole situation isn't ideal, you know? But that's what I have for you. I hope that that helped. Okay. Oh my gosh, I'm about to butcher your name. I am so sorry. Is it Abiha? We have Abiha, and then we have Lauren. Yeah, thank you. I appreciate you. Oh, BB, hello. I was like, wait, what? Or just B. How are you? What are we doing tonight? Oh, thank you. My stomach is so loud right now. What the fuck? Ooh. Okay, let's see. Oh, wrong cleansing stone. Okay. I left home with roommates, got a new car, worked two jobs. Ooh, getting snatched. Whole new beginning. Do you like your roommates? Yes, finally. You deserve it, girl. Spirit. coming next for BB? What does she need to know? Ooh, were your parents upset that you moved out? What's coming next? What do you need her to know? Big time? Yeah, I can see that. Ooh, okay. So I'm going to start by saying that the overall energy is really good, which is good. I think, I don't want to ask if you've gone no contact, but I think now they're happy. Oh, okay, good. That's good to know. I do think that if you go back home to visit, or if there's like a holiday that you go back home for or something like that, I do think that they're going to bother you again, or they're going to bring it up in a very annoying way. Because I can't see who else this would be, like, you know, like you're just living your best life. Unless you like started dating a guy and he's annoying and then you had to break up with him. And I just don't know. We have the Nine of Swords in the reverse and the Ten of Swords. I was like, what? Like, who feels betrayed here? Because you're like, I'm living my best life. I'm like, who's that? Then we have the Eight of Cups reverse. So I'm like, oh, return. Oh. And mom's like, you're not going to come visit? And I'm like, nope. No, I'm not. Only when I have to. You're like, I got out and I'm staying. I'm lagging. Oh, no. I upload the lives on my YouTube every day. So if you need to come back or go back and watch it, it will be uploaded. Okay, we then have the artist. I glitched out. Oh. It says my connection is fine. I'm so sorry. I don't know what happened. But yes, so these first three cards tell me that your parents feel very like betrayed by you, like very dramatic, in a very, very dramatic way. We then have the artist, which is like you creating your new life. You creating your new life. I feel like your parents are going to come at you with something. I can't listen. Wait, what? Are you talking to me? Like about the live? Like you can't hear anything? Or are you talking about your parents? So the first three cards, you didn't miss much. The first three cards are basically your parents just like feeling really betrayed by you leaving. Like it's very, very, very dramatic. Very dramatic energy. But the artist here talks about you starting over and like starting this new life. I think that they're going to bring something up for you again because we have the Ace of Cups reverse and the Devil reverse. They're going to tell you that they feel, this is really dramatic. Okay, tell me when you're back. Let me know when you're back. You're back? Okay. With the Ace of Cups and the Devil both in the reverse, I feel like, dude, this feels so dramatic, but this is what I'm getting. They're going to be like, we feel like you don't love us anymore. We feel like you don't care about us. We feel like you don't want to see us. We feel like you don't want us. We then have the Knight of Cups in the reverse and the World in the reverse. The Knight of Cups in reverse is like feeling rejected. So your parents feel very rejected. And the World in reverse is like unfinished business and repeating cycles. I feel like they're just going to keep... Oh my God, my stomach is growling so loud. What the fuck? It's so dramatic. Like, I'm so sorry. But the Knight of Cups in reverse and the World reverse tell me that like this is something that they're never really going to let go. So I think it's a really good idea that you don't like go back and visit very often. So I think that's a really, really good choice on your part. I don't know why it's not just like I don't know why they're not telling me about anything else. But in the overall, we have the Sun and the Hierophant. So if you're single, I do feel like you have a big relationship coming towards you. Maybe that's why they're talking about your parents. Because if you start dating someone and they found out, maybe they'd be like, well, why can't we meet him? Why can't we meet him? And then it's like this whole thing. The Hierophant is a really big committed relationship or commitment, just in general. And the Sun is happiness. I think that they're also telling you to hold back on like having this person meet your parents. I don't know who the I don't have a lot of details. It's just a committed relationship. But I think your parents are going to like... I've had two people asking if I'm going to get married. Really? Because the Hierophant can be marriage. You must be meeting someone. Let's ask the timing deck. When is BB going to meet this man? So she's going to be all snatched for her man. That's not specific at all. What the fuck? September. It's more my mom than my dad. Oh, interesting. Okay, so the first card we got out was 5 years. And I was like, that's kind of a long time. But then we got September. Because I was like, can I have like... I don't think it's going to be another 5 years before you meet someone. Sometimes they give the 5 years card to be like, it's going to be a while. But September tells me that it's sooner than you think. I don't know. I mean, it depends on how often you're getting out of your house. But the overall is full moon. You're the second person to get this. So there's something about the full moon on September 17th that's going to be really significant for you. They probably gave you the 5 years card. They give me the 5 years card all the time because they don't want me to worry about timelines. They do it to me all the time. So like, I'm right there with you. They don't let me use the timing deck. They don't let me personally use it. It works for other people that I use it on, but it never works for me. So I'm right there with you. Trust me. But one of my biggest problems is that like, I don't know how to stay present. It's very hard for me too. I'm always thinking about what's next. So if you have the same problem, then they're going to give you the same. They're going to give you the same thing. My SB broke up September 16th. That's crazy. No, I don't have a 10 years card. I will not put 10 years in this deck because I'm the only one who will pull it. I will not do that to myself. That's crazy. Like, that's like 2 years to the day. That's weird. Wait, what? Yeah, honestly, I would just stay away from your parents. He must be coming. He might be. Oh boy. Okay. We have Taurus, Leo, and Capricorn here. I don't have much to say other than like, I think they're warning you that your parents are gonna try to be your downfall. But I think you're doing a really good job at not letting that happen. I don't think you need to like stay up at night thinking about it, you know? Like, you're gonna be fine. You're already like doing 10 times better than you were. You know what I mean? Like, the world didn't blow up because you moved out. Like, your parents need to know that. Like, you're happy. You're living with your wonderful roommates. You're hitting the gym. You're getting snatched. Like, clearly you're calling in a man. Like, what the fuck? I don't know, girl. I feel like you have a lot of great stuff coming towards you. And your parents are just kind of like this sleep paralysis demon that you have to deal with every once in a while. Pretty ruined my life as much as they could. They're both narcissists. Yeah, and that's why you moved out, and that's why you're staying away. You know what? If you need to go, no contact with them. Like, do what you need to do, you know? But that's what I have for you. I wish I could tell you more. I have no idea. I don't know. Yeah, don't we all? Don't all of our parents need spiritual healing? But thank you, BB. It was so good hearing from you. Missed you, girl. Oh man, he got you. You're like, as soon as this car is paid off, I'm driving away. My ex came back pretending like nothing happened, but I think he's a soulmate. Did he betray you? I'm also my parents' kid, so I gaslight them. It's just a vicious cycle between you and your parents. Thank you, BB. I appreciate you. Oh my gosh, it was so good to hear from you again. Next we have Lauren. He hides everything. Do you really think that the person you're supposed to end up with would like lie to you? I'm being serious. Thank you, girl. And let me know when your man comes in, because they didn't tell me shit. I just know he wants to be with you. I just know he wants to marry you. The Hierophant is also about religion, so I wonder if he's of the same religion as you. What if your parents try to get you an arranged marriage or something? And your dad's like, well, I bought you a car. Now you gotta marry this man. Hi, Lauren. What are we doing tonight? I want to do a mini love reading. Okay. On anyone specific? Or just what's next? Okay, what's their name? Or initials, if you don't feel comfortable. HT, okay. I'm not going anywhere. Oh, wait. Oh, wait, sorry. Wrong person. William. Okay, we're reading on William. My bad. I was just reading comments. I always forget that you can make the comments big. There we go. Okay, Spirit, can you please tune into William? All that water energy. He's a Scorpio and you're a Cancer. Wow. It must have been very emotional, huh? Are you guys still in contact with each other? Can I have two cards on William's energy? What's he up to? How does William feel about Lauren? Oh, he's scared. Did you like kick him out or something? What are William's intentions with Lauren? Mm-hmm. This man is mad at you. He's mad at you because you like stood up for yourself or something. This is his energy. We have the Queen of Swords and the Wheel of Fortune. He sees you as, you know, these two cards are supposed to be his energy, but I feel like he's just thinking about you. He's upset because you have made some sort of decision that benefits you as opposed to benefiting you both. Sorry, for what? Oh, you're good. Are you back? I didn't really get into it yet. So that's good. What's going on tonight? I don't know what's going on, but you're here now. Okay, so you're good. I didn't really get into it yet. So I was like shuffling and stuff. I did ask though, like, what did I ask? Oh, I don't even remember. He seems really upset with you, though, for making, like, a decision that benefits you as opposed to, like, benefiting you both. Like, he feels really mad at you. Oh, yeah, I was like, did you, like, kick him out or something? Like, he feels, like, upset with you. Like, he feels upset that you're, like, putting yourself first, almost. Like, he feels like you're selfish, but you're not. We have the Wheel of Fortune and the Queen of Swords. It's interesting because those first two cards, I intend to be about his energy. But to me, I feel like you are in that. So like you kind of consume his mind a little bit. And it's, I got pregnant and oh my God, I'm so sorry. I am so, so sorry. He was mad about it? Like mad at you? If he was mad at you, I swear to God, like he was mad at you. That's actually crazy. He's still like upset. What a fucking narcissist. Like what? I know a guy who did that, or like an old friend. Her partner got really mad at her for miscarrying their child. And I was just like, what? And he's like a raging narcissist, but like, okay. Anyway, so this is his energy. He's like really thinking about you. But he's also like, he sees you as someone who is thriving, you know? There's a third party. Oh, wow. That's crazy. I didn't pick up on it. I don't have any third party energy here. Maybe they broke up. Or maybe he's just not taking it as seriously as he'd like everyone to think. He's probably cheating on her. But yeah, he sees you as like thriving. How does he feel about you? We have the Page of Swords. The Page of Swords is like the social media card. So he's definitely watching you. He wants to know what you're up to. He definitely checks in on you a lot. We have the Hermit in the reverse and the Fool in the reverse. That to me says, I'm gonna keep watching, but I'm too scared to say anything. Do I think he blocked you? I don't know if he blocked you. I mean, if he did block you, then I would assume he's watching you from like other accounts, but I think that he's watching you. But yeah, I think that he watches, but he's like too scared to say anything. His intentions with you, we have the Emperor and the Five of Cups in the reverse to start out. So his intentions aren't necessarily to get back together with you. Like his intention, if he were to come back, he would just try to manipulate you, be angry with you. I think he would blame you for the way that like his brother views your stuff. That's weird. I just think that he would, like, there's no intention here on like starting a relationship with you or anything, which is probably a good thing, right? With the Knight of Cups in the reverse, if he came back, his intention would to be to reject you, to like punish you, right? Because this is rejection. The only reason why this man would come back to you is so that he can punish you. Like, that's it. The thing about this reading is that there's no big, like, I love you cards. So this man, like, doesn't feel anything. I don't see anything about a third party. Which, to me, says if he's in another relationship, he doesn't care about them. Overall, we have the Artist and the Ace of Swords in the reverse. The artist is creation, like being artistic. And then the Ace of Swords reverses lies. So he is very manipulative. He does have a whole book of lies that he likes to tell people. You know, I'm sure that he's told people things about you, but it would really surprise me if people believed him because he just seems like a straight up fucking liar. Like that's how he feels to me. And he just keeps an eye on you because he's like, he just wants to know. He probably just wants to know if you're doing better than him, which you probably are. Okay. When is this man going to make a comeback or try? I don't know. When is this man going to try to make a comeback? Did he try to hit you up in July? Why'd we get July? It might be another year. He might do like a little check-in with you in the next 3 to 6 months, but in the next year, he might like try to hit you up, like, and be serious. Oh, they broke up in July. Interesting. Yeah, you'll probably be hearing from him in the next few months. I keep saying, like, I keep telling people that, like, if I'm pulling, like, the holiday cards for you, and I'm, like, or timing cards that, like, are during the holidays, and we're talking about an ex, they're probably going to hit you with the Merry Christmas, like, 3 days. How should I handle that? If he hits you up, I mean, I would block him. If he somehow, listen, toxic people will try to hit you up with the no caller ID. They'll try to email you. I would tell him to leave you alone. I'd be like, leave me alone. And if he doesn't do that, then you hit him with the, I'm filing a restraining order because you won't leave me alone. if you want to get back together with him, I mean, you can try to get back together with him, but this is not a man that you should want to be with. This man seems very narcissistic. He seems very mean. He seems really cruel. And he seems like the kind of person that just is like preying on your downfall. Like, he's watching you and he knows what you're up to. He knows what your life is like. And he keeps track of you on purpose. Well, like I said, in his intentions are to end up rejecting you as like a punishment. So he'll probably come in, sweet talk you. He'll sweet talk you and then he'll break up with you because that's how it always goes. But yeah, I don't know. I don't really know what else to pull from this. I just feel, and like I said, also in the in the overall energy, Ace of Swords reverse, that's lying. Artist is someone who's being creative. Like, he's just gonna lie to you. Scam artist, yeah. You set a trap. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what to say about this. Is there anything else I can pull from this? I think when he comes in, he'll be like, I've been watching you. I've been watching you. You look like you're doing good. You look good. It's going to be something like that. We should get dinner. Let me take you out. We have Aquarius, Virgo, and Aries here. Like, oh, let me take you out. You look good. Like, let's catch up. Yeah. Do you, girl. Let me know how it goes. But that's what I have for you. A very straightforward reading. He's like textbook, like textbook toxic person. Like, if you have the energy for it, I guess go ahead. Yeah, keep me updated. I appreciate you though, Lauren. Thank you. Okay, next we have Emanuela, and that's it. Do you know, I had a reading last week and you were right about getting a win. Ooh, congratulations. Thank you, Lauren. Hello, how are you? I'm okay. I'm tired. But I'm excited because I think tomorrow, me and my friends from back home are going to all get on Discord and watch John Wick. So I'm kind of excited for that. We haven't done that in a while. Man, I miss my friends. I miss my Oregonian friends. I know it is cute, huh? Emanuela, are you here? Hello? Probably. That's why, like, when I break up with my exes, and if I have, like, their family on my social media, I delete and block them, too, because I'm like, no. Hello. Oh, are you Emanuela? E
STE471.
Okay, cool, cool, cool. Let's do it. Tommy. Let's talk about Tommy. Tommy, Tommy, Tommy. I saw Tommy Pickles from Rugrats. Okay. Spirit, please tune in to Tommy. I have two cards on Tommy. What's his energy? Oh, you also got the Wheel of Fortune for him. Interesting. Okay, how does Tommy feel about Emanuela? How does Tommy feel about Emanuela? What are Tommy's true intentions for Emanuela? Oh. Oh yeah, he's coming back. Oh yeah, he's coming back. Jesus Christ. Yeah, my list is open. Whew. Okay. So his energy, we start with the Fool in the reverse and the Wheel of Fortune. The Wheel of Fortune is like the universe is on your side. The Fool in the reverse is like, I don't want to engage in risky behavior. I know I shouldn't do this. He's trying really hard. So like if you guys, let's just say I completely cut him out of my life, but I still feel, yeah. I think that like if he's blocked on everything, he's definitely sitting there like, do I try to reach out to her in this way? You know, do I email her? Do I hit her up through the no caller IDs? He's trying to decide if it's the right time to do that. That's why the Wheel of Fortune is here. Like, is this something I should do? Does the universe support me in this? Does this feel right to do? His feelings for you, we have the Judgment, which is definitely reconciliation. It's definitely reflecting back on the past. This man is like, he feels a little bit obsessed. I don't know what he did. But he said goodbye, but you said goodbye, and he's like not okay with it. We have the Page of Wands, which is messages. So he's trying to find a way. That's also messages of travel. So he's trying to find a way to get to you. He's probably hitting up all the apps, seeing what he's blocked on and what he's not blocked on. We have the Nine of Wands in the reverse, which is okay. That's like I'm getting tired of fighting. So like, he is going through all the apps. He's trying to see what he's blocked on, what he's not blocked on. I think he's hitting a lot of dead ends. He is getting tired, but like he is reflecting a lot on this relationship. Yeah, I would definitely say he's struggling. He's struggling because he doesn't have access to you though. Like I don't see a lot of cards here that say, oh, I'm so in love with you, you know? So he's struggling because you're not taking him back this time. You know what I mean? Like, it's really bothering him that he doesn't know where you're at. He has no idea what you're doing, where you are. Like, he has no idea. It's really, really bothering him. His intentions, we have the Page of Cups, which is love messages. And the Four of Swords reverse, which is we need to heal something. So, I mean, if he did try to come back or if he somehow got through to you, he would definitely hit you with the, I really want to fix this. We have the Eight of Pentacles here, which is putting work into something. I want to start over. I really want to do it right this time. I'm going to do everything that you need me to do. You know, the typical bullshit. And then we have the Nine of Pentacles, which is the happy single card. So it doesn't even matter if you get back together with him or not. You're going to end up single. And I know you know that, but I hope that like from these cards, you see that you made the right decision because either way you end up single. And the Nine of Pentacles is also this indication of like, you're good on your own, which tells me that this man adds no benefit to your life. Like, he just takes and takes and takes from you. Like, there's nothing, he has nothing to offer you. All he does is take from you. So I don't know what he expects. Overall, we have the Page and the Ten of Pentacles in the reverse. If you guys ended up getting married, you two would end up divorced. The Page of Pentacles in the reverse, I think he's upset because, again, he doesn't have access to you. I don't think it was just energy that he took from you. I think he tried to get more from you. Like, I don't know if you paid for his stuff. I don't know if you, like, you know, just provided him with a lot of things. Not like necessarily like bought him Chanel, you know what I mean? But like, you were always there. You were always there to lend a helping hand. Like, that's the energy of the Page of Pentacles. And once in the reverse, like, you don't have access to that anymore and you're missing out. The Ten of Pentacles reverse also tells me that, like, he doesn't care if he breaks up a home. He doesn't respect your space. He doesn't respect the way you provide for the relationship. He just took advantage of it. Provided for him mentally and once financially. Oh, wow. Yeah. Once will be enough, though. You know, once someone, you know, takes money from you one time, sometimes that's enough. Money is like the biggest killer of relationships. It is. It's like the thing that couples most fight about, you know? Okay. I know he's blocked on everything, but when is he going to try to reach back out again? I'm still distraught. You're funny. You're like, that was the worst $20 I've ever spent in my life. When's he going to try to hit her up again? Why is everyone getting September? You also got September. That's like now. Isn't that like tomorrow? Overall, we do have March. So I think he's going to try again in the next month. Obviously, you're not going to know. But he's going to try again in March as well. That is scary. If I knew my ex was going to try to reach out to me in a month, I would literally like hide under my bed until September was over. Wake me up when September ends. Like, no. Absolutely not. Okay, can I pick up on anything else about this man? He's being very strategic. I always get with the Wheel of Fortune that this is like, okay, I just need to wait for the right time. I just need to wait for the right time. He's going to be very careful about what he says too, with the Fool in the reverse. He's going to be very careful. Everything is going to be very curated, very specific. Obviously, you're not going to know because he's blocked on everything. I don't know if you're going to, you know, have a weak moment and unblock him on something. But, you know, if you have one of those moments, sit on your hands, throw your phone across the room, you know, lock it up somewhere. Lock it up somewhere so you don't touch it. Okay, we have Aquarius. Oh, yeah, Aquarius. Aquarius energy here. Yeah, trust no unknown numbers, especially the no caller IDs. The no caller IDs, that's what happens when you're blocked. How do you even call someone no caller ID? How do you do that? Is it like *69 or some shit? I don't even know. Phone will not be used because academics are kind of too much and stuff. Ooh, okay. She said, I'm a scholar. I'm busy. That's what I have for you though, girl. That was very straightforward. All the readings are very straightforward tonight. I don't know what else to say about him. There's a lot of pentacles here though. So I think that like he is definitely big on taking from you energetically and mentally. Like, he's very draining to be around. I hope that helped, girl. I appreciate you. Thank you so much. Oh, apps for fake phone number. That is terrifying. Okay. Thank you, Emanuela. Next, we have Nicole. Remember girls saying to give fake phone number to guys you're not interested in? Oh, yeah. Yeah, if you're scared of saying no, I've rejected guys, though. Can I have your number? No. I'm like, man, am I mean? I don't know. Yeah, these are paid readings. Nicole, will Joey regret ending things and reach out to her? Ooh, okay. With all the reconciliation readings. You know what's interesting is like Mercury Gatorade just ended. The Mercury Gatorade has been drunk. Everyone's like, reconciliation? What's going on with my ex? I guess it's post-shadow, huh? What's his name? I already forgot. Joey. Okay. Joey. When I think of Joey, I think of Joey from NSYNC. And so the third... It's too long. I hate Mercury Retrograde. I'm sorry. Sorry, Joey. You lived with two Joeys? I don't even know if... Have I ever met a Joey? I don't know if I've ever met a Joey. I probably have. I feel really bad if I have. I'm like, who's that? I don't know. Who's Joey? Okay. Spirit, can I have two cards on Joey's energy? Who's the Joey NSYNC guy? Is it Joey Fatone? Am I saying his name right? Oh. How does he feel about Nicole? How does Joey feel about Nicole? Oh. He does, right? When I think of the name Joey, I think of like a Hollister model from like 2004. I don't know why. With like frosted tips. I don't know why. Like, don't come for me. Yes, you're correct. Oh, God. Okay. What are Joey's true intentions with Nicole? You remember when the Hollister models and the Abercrombie models used to like stand outside the stores shirtless? Like, that's how I see Joey's. The Joey's were in NYC. Oh yeah, and then there's Joey from Friends. Not him, but so funny. I'm sorry. You're like, yeah, that is like the complete opposite of the Joey that I know. You want to know if this man is coming back? Yes. Now, is he gonna stick around? That's another story. Is he in love with you? Also another story. The moral of the story is that Joey is all over the place and this man does not know what he wants. God damn it, Joey. Are you guys still talking or are you just totally like what is happening here? Let me see if you said something and I just forgot. Okay. So he ended things, right? He said, does he regret ending things and will he reach out to reconcile? I would say he regrets it. I would say he regrets it for sure. Okay, this is his energy, King of Wands and the Six of Wands. His ego is crazy. Look at that fire energy. What the hell? We were together 4 years, had pregnancy loss. Oh my God, I am so sorry. Started arguing, he ended things. What's with the men tonight who like don't know how to support their women during miscarriages? Like, do they not understand like how grueling it is to go through a miscarriage? I've never been through one, but like I know like I've had friends that have gone through them and they're not fun to go through. It's not like some easy process. Like, it's very painful and it's like, it's physically painful and it's emotionally draining. It's very sad. Like, I don't know why. Okay. Let me keep going. This man has the biggest fucking ego I've ever seen in my life. The Six of Wands, look at him on his high horse. The Six of Wands is about a victory, success. The King of Wands, Alice, who comes in here sometimes, she says that King of Wands is Sagittarius energy. Sagittarians are the celebrities of the zodiac, okay? Leos are the theater stars. Sagittarius, they're the celebrities, okay? This man thinks he's a celebrity. This man thinks he's hot shit. I'm not joking. He thinks he's a catch. I don't know if you agree or not. I'm just telling you how he feels about himself. I think he's an ego problem. Now, how does he feel about you? We have the Queen of Cups here. Definitely in love with you still. He says he's high value. Oh my God. He says he's high value. I'm going to throw up. High value? Someone get this man a trophy. Like a participation trophy. He said it in an argument 2 years ago. I'm going to throw up. DN vibes. Some of these men can't even offer either of those. They're just there being a nuisance. And they're like, I'm high value. Get in the kitchen. Make me a sandwich. Bitch, if you don't get the fuck out of my face and out of my house and out of my life. Does he sprinkle? I'm gonna throw up. Who says that they're high value? Ew! Like, what in that? What's that guy's name? Andrew Tate? What in the Andrew Tate is happening? But making 40K? Okay. Let me keep going. Let me stop yapping. He's very much in love with you, but we have the Three of Wands here. The Three of Wands is like waiting for better ships to come in. This is not a bad card. It's just not a card of like, I'm coming to get you to fix this. This is a, I'm gonna wait this out. Because he's just high value, right? You're just gonna come running back to him, right? I'm gonna throw up. We then have the Four of Swords, which is resting. Yeah, so he has no intention on like coming forward and fixing things. He thinks that you are gonna come forward and fix things, which I hope you don't. I hope he suffers in silence because you don't deserve this. This man has the biggest ego I've ever fucking seen in my life. His intentions, we have the Page of Wands. He will reach out eventually. He will, because he's going to get to the point, it's probably going to be like 3 years from now, and he's still like, where is she? I don't get it. And you're like married with like 10,000 children, and you're like happy. And he's like, I don't get it. I have to hit her up. And you know what? It's always like on the wedding day too, that the exes are like, oh my gosh, you're getting married. Can we meet up one last time? How did you get this number? First of all. Second of all, no. Third of all, Don't bring a rain cloud to my happy day, you fucking nuisance. Anyway, I act like I've personally been through this. Like I've had a wedding day. I have not been through this. Anyway, we then have the Queen of Swords in the reverse, which is someone who's very defensive, and the Knight of Cups in the reverse, rejection. So his intentions are to reach out to you, but nothing's gonna come of it. I mean, he's overly defensive. He thinks he's right at everything, or over everything. I don't know how to say that. The Knight of Cups reverse tells me that he's very scared of rejection. So if he feels any sort of energy coming from you of like, I don't wanna be with this guy, he's gonna immediately like cut it off and be like, no, fuck you. Overall though, we have the Empress and the Seven of Cups. I do feel like he is talking to other people, but the Empress tells me that he's still thinking about you. He still kind of puts you up as like number one, but he's never going to say that out loud. And that's the problem, because he's just so high value. He's so high value. Ew. Okay. When is this man coming back? Yeah, exactly. Well, fall. Okay. All right. Now, if you have a favorite holiday, he'll probably hit you up on that favorite holiday. if you really like Halloween, if you're a Halloween girl, he's gonna be like, happy Halloween, what are you doing for Halloween? Witchy vibes, hashtag witchy vibes. Have you gone to Home Goods yet for the Halloween Hello Kitty, you know? If you're a Christmas girl, you know, he'll hit you up on Christmas. Merry Christmas. If you like Thanksgiving, happy Thanksgiving. Hope you're having a great day. Hope you're having a great day with your family. He'll do something. Overall energy, we do have January. So it could be New Year's as well. I feel like it's happening. It's happening soon. I think between probably like October and January, you'll hear from him. I don't know what else to say about this man. I want to say Sagittarius and Leo since we were talking about it, and Taurus. I hope that helped. Mine broke up with me in October knowing it was my favorite. Literally Satan. That's spooky. That's a true spooky Halloween experience. You know what would be really scary? If like, I think like my own personal hell would be like me getting to the gates of hell and then Satan being like, the first thing we're doing is taking you in a haunted house full of your exes. And you have to like revisit all of your worst moments. That is a haunted house. Oh, he's Taurus? Oh, interesting. Unhealed Taurus energy is very gluttonous. They have to have everything for themselves. Okay. Thank you, Nicole. I appreciate you. Next, we have Andrea, and then we have, why is it formatted like that? And then we have Luisa. And then we have Victoria. Yeah, playing this song, right? It's my least favorite song. He seems unhealed. He seems like he's being run by the ego. Oh, is it you? Is it? I just said Andrea. Is it Ars? Is that you, Andy? A Taurus man named Joey calling himself high value just makes so much sense. Not Joey the high value man. Not Joey the high value Taurus. RC, my bad. I was like, that's probably not correct. Anyways, what are we doing tonight? Okay, and I'm gonna close my list now. So Angel is the last person. My list is closed after that. I'm sorry. It's almost 9 o'clock. I haven't. General? Okay. I'm in California. All right, Spirit. What's coming next for Andy? Oh, it fell in my lap. Oh, okay. Okay. Oh yeah, that's late, 11. See, I don't wanna be on here till 11. That's too late, it's too late. I have dramas to watch. After 9 o'clock is my creative time. So like, okay. So we start with the King of Cups and the Hermit, both in the reverse. someone's coming out of the woodworks to talk to you, but they're very like emotionally charged. They seem unhappy. We then have the Fool and the Seven of Cups in the reverse. Oh, is this her, you think? I never like to assume until I'm like super sure, but if you feel like that's her, yeah, it feels very, I was literally about to say, like, is it someone younger than you? Like less, like not as mature. Seven of Cups reverse is feeling overwhelmed. It definitely feels like a child being put in timeout. Yeah. Yeah, like who else would be upset with you, I guess. Why do people keep saying that to me? Who is this Quinn? Who is this Quinn? Let me look this up real quick because I can't. Is this gonna make me upset? Oh my God. I'm so fucking dead. That's actually really funny. That's really funny. So I've gotten Quinn from Big Brother, and I've also gotten Chapel Roan. So no, I'm not offended at all. I'm like, who is this person? The last reality TV show that I was really invested in was Jersey Shore. So anyway, yeah, okay, Andy, sorry. That's like the second time someone's called me Quinn from Big Brother. Okay. I have a feeling one of my people is going to confront her. One of your people? What do you mean? I'm not doing any free readings, I'm sorry, and my list is closed. I'm so sorry. Okay. We then have the Chariot in the reverse and the Page of Cups in the reverse. So she's feeling really overwhelmed, which is what we saw in the first row. It feels very like emotionally charged, like she's just coming at you, but there's no plan. Like that's what it feels like. Why would they reach out to her? The Chariot in the reverse is like, whoa, stop, like stop the car. And the Page of Cups is like loving messages. I think that she might be in the process of like, or not be in the process, but she might get tempted at some point to like be impulsive and like say something impulsively to you. Like maybe she gets drunk one night or something like that. It's very like out of the blue where she feels impulsive, but something pulls her back. Something's gonna pull her back. So it would be kind of funny if like someone that you know, one of your family members or friends like stopped her and was like, hey, don't do that, you know? We then have the Wheel of Fortune and the Ace of Cups. So I think when she feels impulsive or she feels like angry about to text you, I think something is gonna be like, okay, stop. And she's gonna stop and really think about it, and then she's gonna try to come at you more lovingly with the Ace of Cups here. We then have the Five of Swords. I think she's concerned that you're not going to hear her out. Like overall, we have the Five of Pentacles and the Ace of Swords both in the reverse. So this is like abandonment, trying to come out of the cold after feeling abandoned, but this is lying. Or not having clarity, I guess I should say. I don't feel like she's lying about anything. Like something just isn't clear. I think that she's like concerned because she doesn't know like what exactly you're gonna say back. I just feel like even after this conversation, it's still going to be unclear where you guys stand. That's what's frustrating about it. But that's how it always is with you guys. Like, it's really, really good, but it's still confusing. Okay, when is this happening? When is she coming back to Andy? Why is everyone getting June? Like, the past. Like, what the fuck is happening? Dot hair. We then have 6 to 12 months. Why such a long time frame? Yeah, I think that's where, like, the lack of clarity comes in, too, right? It's like she'll come in and, like, tell you how much she loves you. But, like, at the end of the day, she's not going to commit to you. Or maybe not that, but, like, nothing's clear. Like, what are we doing, you know? I don't know what else to pull from this, but I feel like if you get, like, random angry energy and you weren't feeling angry at all, I think that's her. We have Cancer, Aquarius, and Virgo here. You guys, I think I'm going to get the crisscross chair from TikTok shop. I've only gotten one thing from TikTok shop, and that was, like, a t-shirt from a small business. I haven't... Oh, no, I got the hair trimmer, too. That didn't work on me. The legit fought back tears random. Ooh, yeah, that was probably her. That's probably her. It's probably her energy. Oh, you have one? You have one? What color do you have? I want the pink one. Hello? I'm so happy you're here. All caps. I love it. But Andy, that's what I have for you. I don't know what else to say about this girl. Okay. My list has been closed for a minute, so I'm going to refund those of you that paid after I closed my list. I am so sorry. So I'm going to refund Sid. Let me do this real quick. I am so sorry. And then... Okay. Oh, Manny pay. Okay. That's fine. Because you said you were going to get one earlier. Okay. That's it. If anyone purchases another reading, I'm going to have to refund you. I'm so sorry. Because it's almost 9:00. Okay. Next, we have Louisa. Then we have Victoria, Brittany, Angel, and Manny. You're going tonight? You're good, Manny. I know you said you were gonna purchase earlier, so. I was, like, waiting for it to come through. Louisa? Are you here? Everyone's getting X readings. It's so funny to me tonight. What is happening? Oh, hello, girl. Let's do it. That's true. You did ask for general. I'm sorry. You're a statistic in my life now. I hope you have fun at the bar, though. And if she's there, maybe she's super drunk and she'll just be like, I love you. And that's the impulsiveness. All right, Spirit, please tune in to Louisa. Right? I know. Mine too. I journaled last night for the first time in like 80 years. And they were like, finally. Whatever. Whatever. All right, Spirit. What is coming next in love for Louisa? Girl, are you okay? I'm only 2 cards in. Did something happen? Or like in the last year, did something happen? Well, thank you. Yes, let us know how the bar goes. If she's there, update us.
Ooh, oh my God.
What the hell? I have gone through a big breakup. I'm the beginning, in the beginning of the years. Okay. Girl, all that heartbreak, it's not going to matter when you meet this person. I rarely say this. I don't think this is an ex, so don't come at me with that. Alex, do I know him? No! I'm just messing with you. I rarely say this. I think you are meeting your person. Like, that's absolutely fucking crazy. I'm jealous of this reading. When this happens for you, like, please update us, okay? I randomly caught an old video. An old video? Oh God, which one? This is crazy. I know other people are like, what are the cards? What is it? The anticipation. So the first three cards, I was kind of like, ooh, are you okay? You know, we have the Ace of Cups in the reverse, which is like, I'm not okay. I'm feeling insecure. And then we have the Three of Swords, which is like, heartbreak. You definitely spent some nights in the Heartbreak Hotel. Let me tell you, I can feel it. I can see it. Then we have the Fool in the reverse. You got to the point where you're like, I'm giving up. Fuck love. I'm giving up. No more. I feel like you hit rock bottom. Like, that's what I get from the first two cards. Like, that feels like rock bottom to me. Like, you really hit, like, you couldn't breathe. Like, that's how heartbroken you were. Like, you were, like, I remember, like, when I was, like, super heartbroken, like, a couple years ago. I remember I would cry so hard that I, like, couldn't breathe. Like, yeah, that's kind of, like, what I see. If you didn't do that, I'm just being dramatic. I'm sorry. Anyway. Let's get into the good stuff. I feel like you got to this point where you're like, I'm giving up. I'm whatever. I'm excited to see what the timing card is. I'm going to pull it at the end just to see. Just for the anticipation of it all. But we have the King of Wands here. The King of Wands is somewhat, it could be a fire sign. Aries, Leo, Sag. But he's very loyal, very charismatic. He's my favorite king in the deck. He's super hot. So he's like, he's so hot, dude. King of Wands is like he's fine. He's fine. He could be a creative person as well. I don't know if you're like an artist of any kind, but like he could be an artist. He could just be a boss. Like he could manage something. I feel like he's a leader, right? It's Leo energy, like leader. Leader. He's very popular as well. If he's like introverted, he just like, everybody likes him, you know? He just has a really good reputation. We then have the Sun, happiness. We then have the World, a new beginning. We have the Ten of Pentacles, which is the best love card in the deck. This is like you getting married. I don't know if you want marriage. If you don't want marriage, you can set that aside. But this is like, this is getting everything you could ever want. This is my favorite card. Look, there's a dog. There's, you know, a grandpa. It represents generational wealth. This is the white picket fence with the dream house. That's what I'm saying. These cards are crazy. Like, this is getting everything you could ever want. This is the empire. This is the person. The 2.5 kids. The everything. Like, and then we have the Queen of Wands, which came out under the... I'm getting chills. Which came out under the King of Wands. We have a true pair on the board and they're both upright for once. Are you a fire sign? That's what I'm saying. Like, absolutely crazy. Oh, thank you for stopping in. You're an Aries? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. In the overall, it just like gets better. Like, it just gets better. How can it get better than that? I don't know. But it does. No, overall, we have the Ten of Wands in the reverse and the Ace of Pentacles. This is like you getting a ring. This is a gift from the universe. It's like something tangible, something you can hold, touch. You should be cheesing and then send that energy over here because I'm waiting for my husband to just like fall through my ceiling at this point. The Ten of Wands in the reverse is like releasing burdens. This person who you're meeting is going to be everything and then some. Like, they're not just someone who's like, I want to take care of you. They're the guy who, like, I don't know. You say, oh, I wish, you know, my shower, I wish, you know, my bathroom had a bunch of lights in it. It would be really cool. But you don't really think much about it because it's like, whatever. Like, who cares about having lights in your bathroom? Like, ooh, I wish I had like a cool spa bathroom. And then you just like come home one day and he just like made you a spa in the bathroom. And you were just like, yeah, I just threw that together. And it's just like nothing. Like, you don't have to ask this man for anything. Like, it's like he anticipates what you need. Oh my God forbid. That right need. I'm like, I'm like hee-heeing over this reading. This is crazy. It's like, it's beyond provider though. Like, it's beyond that. It's just like, it's like, he's just a genuinely good partner. Like, yeah, he has money. Yeah, he gives you money. But like, this isn't him being like, oh yeah, I'm a provider. Like, this is just who he is. He's just a good partner. He's just a good person. And you guys fit together very perfectly. He could be from like a different state, city, country than you with the world here. So, or maybe you guys are from different cultures, different backgrounds, like different economic backgrounds. It's something different. But you guys fit. It's not going to be a problem. Like, this is so exciting. Okay, when is this happening? Yeah, I mean, like every normal person. Yeah, you sound like a normal human being, so don't worry. You're not crazy. Wow, that's specific. We have winter and January. You could be meeting them in January. Now, it depends on, you know, are you leaving your house? You know, if you're held up in your room all day and you're not on the apps, I don't know how you're going to meet this man. But just make sure you're out and about this winter, okay? Make sure you're looking up. Keep your eyes open. And we do have Aquarius energy here with the Fool. We have Aquarius and Leo heavily showing up here. And we'll say Aries too, since I said fire. And you're an Aries. That's what I have for you. I don't know what else to say. Like, what the fuck? I didn't have that in my past, so it's a non-negotiable for me moving forward. And that's what's calling this person is because in, because you're not settling, you know? But that's what I have for you, girl. I hope that that helped. Like, Jesus Christ, I have to like take a moment. I appreciate you for getting a reading from me. Thank you. I needed that positivity tonight. That was wild. What the fuck? Okay. Next we have Victoria, and then we have Brittany, Angel, and Manny. Oh, thank you. Yeah, very loud card. Screaming in a good way. Hello, what are we doing tonight? I don't know if anyone can really top that reading. I don't think I've ever gotten that good of a reading. And clearly I'm still single, so I don't know. No, my list is closed. I'm sorry. General, yeah. See what's coming up. See what's coming next. All right, Spirit, please tune into Victoria. What is coming next for Victoria? What does Victoria need to know? What is coming next for her? Did you have a falling out with a friend? If not, let me reinterpret that. You're like, multiple. Which one are we talking about? Be like that sometimes. Okay. Ooh, this person caused a lot of drama. Like, a lot. There's a lot of people here. This feels messy. What's crazy is that I don't see an apology. So I'm like, why? You know? Okay, so we start with the Judgment. Like, I know who it is. Judgment. Right off the bat, reconciliation. We then have the Nine of Swords in the reverse. This is someone who caused a lot of mental health issues for you. Like, a lot. Like, so I don't know if they spread rumors about you, were lying about you, or just being mean, you know? We then have the Four of Cups in the reverse. This is someone who's constantly in other people's business, okay? Four of Cups is like, I don't know how to stay present. It's looking at things that you don't need to be fucking looking at, okay? Like, this person is always up in other people's business when they should be worried about their own. We then have the Page of Pentacles, which is the friendship card to me as a reader. It's like a friend lending a helping hand. This is also like a friend reaching out and being like, hello, want to get coffee? Something simple. So I think they're coming in, and I think that like the assumption will be that there's an apology coming. But it might, if it is an apology, it's going to be very like backhanded. Does that make sense? You know, when people try to apologize, but it's not actually apologizing. It's kind of like in Mean Girls when Katie was like, I can't help that you're obsessed with me or something. You know, it's kind of like that. What the fuck? Okay. We then have the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse, which this is, she's having stability. I don't know what the gender of this. I just said she. I just figured this is like an ex, like girlfriend, you know? Friend girl. She? Okay. She's having stability issues. I'm guessing she doesn't have any friends left, and she's burned bridges. And she's trying to rebuild some of them. That's what that feels like to me. Like, she has nothing left. Queen of Pentacles reversed. Five of Wands. Drama. Conflict. Too many cooks in the kitchen. Hierophant in the reverse. Rebellion. She's very transactional. She brings a lot of people into her drama, too. That's what I get from the Five of Wands. And, you know, I think she views her bad attitude as like, I'm just like a rebel. I'm just like, nobody gets me. I'm just like unique. Like, nobody understands me. No, bitch. Like, you're just crazy. we don't understand you because we have decorum. Like, what? We then have the Six of Pentacles. I feel like everything, like, Six of Pentacles is usually like generosity, but like, I think she thinks she's being generous, but it's actually transactional, you know? Overall, we have the Knight of Cups reverse and the Queen of Swords. So I think if she does get a hold of you, if she's not blocked on everything, be very careful about what you say. Queen of Swords, Knight of Cups in the reverse. That's rejection. I would let her down really easy. If she wants to meet up with you, just be like, hey, no, like, I'm busy. If she says some other time, or if you, or be like some other time and just like never speak to her ever again or something. I don't know. But I feel like she's the type of person that if you don't like tread lightly, she's going to start drama. Do you know what I mean? So I think like just let her down really easy. Okay. When is this girl coming in? I'm sorry. That's what came up for you. When is she coming back? I think between September and December, because we have 1 month and December. The holidays for everyone. I don't know what's going on. We have lots of Taurus energy here. Lots of Taurus. Definitely one of those people. I don't know what else to pull. From this. I just feel like she's burnt a lot of bridges and she's going to try to rebuild some of them. But like, I would not start a friendship with her again. But I also wouldn't like call her a bitch, because I feel like she would take that and run with it. And we don't want that. No, my list is closed. I'm sorry. You're back already? Same night? Oh God, can I pull anything else from this? I don't think so. She's very like delusional. Like, go to therapy. If it's collective, I want nothing to do with that. She's the Lulu. Thank you, girl. I appreciate you. I hope it helped. That was probably not the happy, joyous reading you were looking for. A nice little warning. Okay. But you know, who knows? You know, she may get scared and not reach out at all, you know? You just never know. Some people change their mind. Let's hope so with her. We have Brittany, Angel, and Manny. Brittany, are you here? Is Brittany here? Brittany? Does anyone remember Brittany from Fairly Odd Parents? Oh, thank you. Okay, I'll give Brittany a couple more seconds and then we'll go to Angel. I haven't watched the Fairly Odd Parents in a minute. Usually I watch like my favorite childhood shows for like nostalgia, but Fairly Odd Parents is one of those ones that I haven't like revisited. Yeah, Brittany, it was so, God, the Fairly Odd Parents used to scare me. Like, low-key. Like, the way that some of those parents, like, treated those kids. Like, it's like, it used to, like, low-key scare me. And then you guys remember the episode where Timmy, or was it an episode or was it, like, a full movie? I can't remember. But it was when he wanted to be older. But then, like, he realized that, like, if he got older, then the Fairly Odd Parents would go away and then he would forget them forever. And I was like, what the fuck? Ooh, you've been watching it? Ooh, maybe I should watch it again. Odd Parents, Fairly Odd Parents. Are Brittany or Angel here? Are either of you here? Did they fall asleep? Brittany? Brittany? Or if Brittany, if you're putting comments, I don't see them. I'll just put that out there because sometimes that happens too. Okay, that's what I thought. I was like, I feel that like that was like a longer episode. Is Angel here? I feel like I see Brittany in the room. Maybe she fell asleep. I think I see her picture up there. Unless that you guys just look really similar. Is Manny here? Hello? I know it's really late where everyone's at. Oh, I also remember in the Fairly Odd Parents when Manny... Okay, let's do Manny's reading because... And then we'll call for Brittany and Angel again. I remember that episode of Fairly Odd Parents when they... Or when he realized, like, every time he wished for something, it was taken from somebody else. And then, like, he, like, cleared out, like, a Walmart. Do you guys remember that episode? I remember that, too. That was a good lesson, though. Like, be careful what you wish for, right? I just remember, like, being so frustrated with Timmy's parents. Like, no wonder you have Fairly Odd Parents. Your parents are horrendous. Okay. Sounds good. Christine and Manny. What's coming next in love for Manny? What would you like her to know? They were. And his babysitter, Vicky, Icky Vicky. She was evil. She used to piss me off because she was like evil, evil. Ooh. Girl, be careful. You can probably like pinpoint who this is. Since you're talking to a few people, you're probably trying to weed people out, you know? But we have the King of Cups. It was fire. One of my songs on MySpace was you know how you could put, you know, your own songs on your profile? Mine was My Shiny Teeth and Me. So, yeah, that was 8th grade Alex. So, My Shiny Teeth and Me. Shiny teeth, shiny teeth. Yo, I hit that note. Do you guys hear that? I hit that. Okay. We start with the King of Cups in the reverse and the Fool in the reverse. Why is everyone getting the Fool in reverse tonight? That is the card of the night. There's someone here who is very emotionally unavailable, very immature, like zero emotional intelligence. I feel like he's going to try to play in your face. But I don't think he's smart enough to play in your face. So, like, that's the thing. I don't really see you falling for this. But, like, if you entertain it, it can become really toxic. Okay, so how will you know who this person is? We have the Eight of Pentacles in the reverse and the Five of Wands in the reverse. He's one of those guys who claims to not be a lot of drama, but like he actually is. Like he'll talk about his past situations and you'll be like, yeah, you're definitely the problem. What? Eight of Pentacles reverse is also someone who's lazy. So he's the kind of guy who like doesn't put in effort and then doesn't understand why people don't want to be around him or why girls don't want to be with him. And then he like fights or causes drama because he's getting defensive. He's definitely like sassy and not in a cute way. You know, it's funny to talk to a guy with like an attitude, but like only if it's like funny. He's like sassy, like he's like a princess or something. We then have the Seven of Pentacles and the Four of Swords in the reverse. You are going, like, I need you to make a swift decision about this man because I feel like he's overpowering all the other guys that you're talking to. Like, there's too much energy being spent on him. Or if, like, if you choose to keep talking to him, like, you'll find yourself spending too much energy on him. Two I'm talking to right now are actually putting the work in. Oh, that's good. This must be, like, a warning then for, like, a future guy. Because, like, who else would this be? So you must not have met him yet. But here's the thing, though. Like I said, I don't really see you giving to this. So it's almost like you meet this guy out of nowhere. Maybe you kind of add him to the roster. You just want to see where it goes, you know? But once you see a red flag, like, please leave. Please dip out. Like, don't even deal with this. We then have the Three of Cups in the reverse and the Tower in the reverse. That's like third party energy, avoiding reality. Like this man feels delusional. Now, if this isn't someone that you haven't already met yet, and this reading is about the two guys that you are talking to, I would say pay very close attention to how these guys are still acting in a month. I think really toxic people, this is just my theory, but I think really toxic people start to show who they truly are after about 3-4 weeks. Because if they haven't gotten what they wanted after about a month, then they start to either like slip, they start to get bored, you know, like depending on what they want, I don't know what it is, right? But like, if you guys have been talking for longer than a month, really start to pay attention to who is still taking you out on dates, who is still, you know, talking to you every day. Obviously, if one of them dips out for like 5 days in a row, then no more. You don't ever have to talk to him again. Like, you have your answer. I do feel like as well, I don't know what they've told you. I mean, you're talking to multiple people, so you probably don't care. But again, if this reading is about these guys, I do feel like they're also talking to multiple people, regardless of what they're telling you. One of them been asking me on a date, but I keep not saying anything. Do you want to go out with him? If you don't like him, I would just say no. Overall, we have the Three of Pentacles and the Devil in the reverse. Yeah, that to me, okay, Three of Pentacles reverse is like, don't collaborate. And the Devil in reverse is like, release toxicity. That to me as a combo says like, don't get involved with anyone if there's even some sort of inkling that something's off. So if the guy that keeps asking you out on a date, if he's like weird or you're just like, I don't know, like I would just say no, like don't do it. I do, but I don't know, maybe I'm stuck in the past. I mean, just go on the date, see what happens. But if he makes you feel weird, like you don't have to go out on a date with him. Like the world isn't gonna end if you don't go out on a date with him. There's plenty of guys out there who would love to go out on a date with you, you know? I genuinely feel though, like you're about to meet like a fucking princess, man. He's fine and you're like hesitant? Girl, at least go out on the date so you can stare at him. And then you can decide if you want to simp over the past. I don't know. I'm just saying, I think the most important thing to take away from this reading is that I don't really see you giving to this. Like, I think they're just warning you, like, hey, there's this guy that's going to come around. He's going to try to, like, be a princess with you, you know? Okay. When is this guy coming around? You know what I need to do? I need to make a now card. Now. Now 18. Ooh, I think you have a while. We have April and May. So you have a while. I wonder why they're warning you this far out. I wonder if it's like an X or something. We then have full moon, which is releasing energy. Why is everyone getting full moon? That's so crazy. Yeah, it might be an X. Because why the fuck would you even enter? I don't know. This is like really far out for someone new. Or like a bad experience for someone new. Like, why would they warn you this far out? That's so weird to me. I don't know what else to pull from this. That's weird. We have Capricorn, Aquarius, and Scorpio. Yeah, now you know. Now you know. Girl, that's what I have for you. I hope that helped. Girl, go out on the date with the fine man. Go out on the date. Go have dinner. Go get yourself a free meal with a fine man. Fine. When I was little, one of my best friends in elementary school, her name was Monticia. And Monticia called me. This is back when we had answering machines. She called me. This was back when Freddy versus Jason came out. So I know I just aged myself. But she called me, left me a voice message on the answering machine. My mom goes to play it. We get home one day and she goes, girl, you need to call me so we can talk a little something about Freddy versus Jason. And then started talking about, oh, he's so fine. So that's what Foyne reminded me of. Oh, that was so funny. I wish we still had answering machines. I don't know why she would say that. Little kids say the craziest things. So why would she think either of them are Foyne? I don't know. Don't ask me. I don't know. We were little. Thank you, girl. If the other one asks me that again, I will go, yes, do it. And then let us know. Foyne. Dude, she was so funny. You need to call me so we can talk a little something. Like, who says that as a little kid? Okay. You remember when you used to give your phone number out as a little kid and then you'd call the house phone? Okay. Thank you, Manny. I appreciate you. Okay. Brittany or Angel, are you guys here? You guys remember the Proud Family when Dijonay was like, girl, he's not cute. He's fine. Oh my God. I love the Proud Family. I am, but my list is closed. I'm so sorry. Dude, Angel is so funny. She was like, you haven't read me in a while. I'm like, I know. I haven't read you in a while. And then she probably fell asleep. Okay. Does anyone have any like spiritual questions for me or personal questions for me while we wait for Brittany or Angel? I feel bad because like if you guys are in here and you're putting in comments, I do not see them. Like they're not coming up. And I know that happens sometimes. If that's the case, please email me. And then we can work something out. I can do a little mini reading privately and I can send it off to you or something, you know? Does no one have any personal questions for me? We already did a collective, so I'm out. Brittany or Angel, are you guys in here? Doesn't mean you mention a sign. Leo is here. Oh, so each of the cards is represented by a zodiac sign. So like the Emperor is Aries. The Lovers is Gemini. So I usually go off, like, I don't like to name every single sign since every single card has a zodiac sign. The wands is fire signs, cups is water, swords is air, and pentacles is earth. So if there's like a whole mix, I'm not going to be like, oh, every single sign is here. Like, that doesn't make sense. So I usually go off like the major arcana, or if it's just, if there's just like an overwhelming amount of like wands cards, I'll be like, okay, Aries, Leo, Sag is very present here, you know. Any new projects, dude? I'm trying to get out to Oregon to do location scouting for the movie that my friend and I are working on, but it's been hard. And yeah, that reminds me, I need to call him, so thank you for asking that. yeah, it's been hard. It's just, it's expensive to make movies, guys. It's expensive. So, but other than that, no. I'm just working on, like, my own writing projects. The industry is changing a lot, so I'm trying to, like, gauge where the industry is at and, like, where I should be going. Hello, Nicole. Is the sign a true? Oop. Oh my gosh, there's so many people asking me to go live. I'm about to get off. I'm so sorry. But I feel bad. Three people at once just asked me to go live. What does that mean? Was I about to be brought into a room? What does that mean? Okay, is the sign attributed to a person or that calendar time? To a person? You mean like the person I'm reading on? So like, let me just choose a bunch of cards. The judgment and the well are not good examples. So those don't have zodiac signs. Okay, wait. Go to the tower. Okay, there we go. Oh, you're good. I appreciate that. Thank you. Yeah, no, I have a ton of family and friends up there, so I'm good. Thank you, though. Okay, so if we have, like, the Page of Pentacles, that's, like, Earth, but it's not a lot of Earth. But if we have, like, the Chariot and the Tower here, this is Cancer. This is Cancer energy, and this card is represented by Scorpio. So I could be like, yeah, there's some earth energy here, but I think there's a lot of water. I kind of just go with like the majority, and it can resonate as your sign, but it can also be like the person that you're dealing with. So if I'm reading on an ex, I could be like, oh, you know, are they a Scorpio or a Cancer? You could be a Scorpio or a Cancer, or it could just be the energy of the reading. So like if someone is in a lot of Cancer energy, they could be feeling very emotional. It's a very feminine sign. Scorpio, they could be feeling pretty dark, pretty shadowy. So it just depends. I just kind of list off the signs to see if they resonate with people, if that makes sense. I hope that makes sense. Okay, I'm going to do one last call because I feel bad. Brittany or Angel, are either of you here? No, you're good. Don't worry. And everybody reads differently. You know, like, even some of my favorite readers will, like, list off 11 out of 12 of the zodiac signs and be like, all these signs are here. But, like, that to me, like, that doesn't usually resonate with me because I'm like, okay, well, that's everyone, you know? But it doesn't mean it's wrong. But, like, I feel like it depends on the reader on how they, like, list the zodiac signs or if they even talk about them at all, you know? Some won't. I've never seen a reader that doesn't talk about the zodiac signs in their readings, but because, like, astrology and tarot are very interconnected. But is interconnected a word? I don't know. Yeah, and if any of you guys start reading, like, you're going to have your own unique way of doing things, too. Doesn't make it wrong, necessarily. So you have all the Swords cards that are Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, but the Lovers and the Magician are Gemini. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I don't know where Brittany and Angel are, so I think I'm going to get off for the night. I will go ahead and refund them both. I feel like I see them in the room. I'm guessing they just fell asleep or TikTok is blocking them, and I feel really bad. Brittany or Angel, if you can hear me and your comments are being blocked, please email me. Please email me, okay? In my first reading from you, every song mentioned was connected to someone I deeply love. Every sign. Oh, yeah. And sometimes the signs resonate and sometimes they don't, you know? That man's court date. Why is his court date being pushed back? He did something heinous. Oh, thank you. Happy moving. A quick collective. I'm about to do a collective for my page after this. So let's pull a timing card. So everyone think about a question that you have, like a timing question for, like, when am I going to meet the love of my life? When am I going to meet the love of my life? That's crazy. He did something crazy. Like, why would they push that? I don't understand. He needs to be convicted now. All right, everyone think of your timing question. You can say it out loud. You can say it in your head. You can put it in the comments if you want. You don't have to. It all counts. Ooh, that's specific. We have February and March. So I want to say end of February, beginning of March. I didn't even ask anything. Should we do another one? All right, one more. Oh. I think I pulled that pretty quickly. But if you guys already had your question, we have wait, May. And then the overall is summer. So end of May into summer. Okay, let me actually think of a question. All right, we're gonna do another one. Okay. Got February again. And then 6 to 12 months. Something about February. Interesting. That's what I have for you guys. Okay. Not me asking and I'll stop thinking of Joey and you saying May, the month he's born. You're just like, try to like erase his memory. You're like, his birthday month is coming. I must stay strong. Okay. Again, Angel and Brittany, if you can like hear me and the comments are not working for you or something, please email me so we can like work something out. I can do your readings privately. I am going to refund you guys. So if I refund you, obviously you'll have to send payment again. But like, I feel bad because I feel like I see you two both in the room. So I don't know what's going on. I'm guessing you two fell asleep. But I'm going to go film a collective for the Tiki Talks. And and then I'm going to refund Angel and Brittany. And I will see you all on Monday. I don't go live on the weekends, but I will be here on Monday, okay? So everyone, don't go back to your ex while I'm gone, okay? It's only 2 days. Love you guys so much. I will see you guys later. Bye.